unbeaten young Sean Fennell here with us, Manchester's Fight Factory, getting your hands wrapped here, and just doing a bit of preparation for the Ultimate Boxer coming up.
Yeah, under 2 weeks to go now, so it's the final stretch of camp, just getting ready now, final few little touches, and then it's fight time.
Yeah. Bringing your trainer, manager, Mr. Sean Krull.
Hiya, how are you, okay?
I'm alright, I'm good.
Good stuff.
You're on countdown mode. There's been a bit of a delay for the show, but the show must go on.
Yeah, 100%, 100%. And Sean's out. We've got big things planned for him, and he's got big things planned for himself. So it's all systems go. Let him show the world what he's doing every day, because he's dedicated himself to the game now. So we just got to go out there, make people take notice of his talent, and he's growing all the time. He's only 19, and we've got at least another 2 years of learning before we can take the leash off and unleash him. So yeah, he's not had an extensive amateur career, so everything he's doing now is learning, and every fight he's stepping up another level.
Are you looking forward to getting unleashed, Sean?
I am, definitely. Yeah. Definitely.
You've got one of them faces that, you know, like, I have to call you the silent assassin, or the baby face assassin.
No, you know what, in the camp they call him Sugar Sean.
Sugar Sean, alright, okay. Sean.
Not because I eat too many sweets.
No.
Because my boxing's sweet.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's a big pseudonym,
know,
to live up to.
Yeah. Very, very.
You've had some good performances though, haven't you?
Yeah.
You know, and your confidence seems to be building with every fight.
Definitely. I feel like every time I'm getting into the ring as a professional, I'm more relaxed. Not in the sense of where I don't take it serious. I'm more relaxed as I know what I can do in my performance. My preparation, every time it's getting better and better. Learning how my body works. And now I'm becoming settling down as a proper professional, you know what I mean? And that does take a while, but I feel like I'm getting there now.
I can see it happening. And Sean,
yes.
You know, this is, you know, we've been on some decent platforms, but this one is the biggest. It's the BT Sport, you know, a lot of people could watch this. So are you sort of going to be talking about putting on a show? Do you have to change the game plan slightly because the platform's bigger?
Yeah, no, I mean, that's a fair statement to make. I do think that he's also, he realizes Sean is a very smart lad. He knows that with every performance and the bigger the stage gets, he's got to step up to the plate. And as I said before, that now is the time for him to showcase himself. You never know what's going to happen with me in the future. It's all about him as much as it is about us. It's also about him. So he's got to go out there every time, showcase potential sponsors, potential promoters. This is all part of the journey. And if you're not smart enough to take, you know, to take advantage of all these opportunities that are presented to you, because it's a great opportunity, not many young fighters get this opportunity to go on to, you know, you've been around. They're still fighting the small hall shows. 19, fourth professional fight, BT Sport, Ultimate Boxer. You just got to say thank you, you know, give praise that you are granted these opportunities. And Sean's smart enough. I've been around him a long time, going for 4 years now. And besides the physical connection between us, we've got a good spiritual connection too, you know. We understand each other. He's in the ring, I don't even need to speak. He just knows what I need. He knows what I'm looking for. He knows what I'm thinking. I know what he's thinking. And we're just here to help each other, with all other lads in the gym. And I've got the right man with me now, Paulie. And Paulie's got that same type of ethic that I have. And we've had lads before that have come in that have not done the thing, and we've not had a connection with them, and it's no point holding them back and them holding us back. So we just have to say to them, listen lads, move on, because this is not the place for you. But everyone that is here now is meant to be with us, you know.
Yeah, I hear you. And Sean, then you're settled now in your camp, you've got everything, you know, you've not had any chopping and changing, you know what I mean? So sometimes that can get in the way of a fighter's progression, chopping and changing.
In terms of what?
You've been with Sean since you turned over, there's not been any disruptions to that.
I don't think there's any need. Like people say, if
if a light bulb don't need fixing, don't fix it, you know what I mean? I think we've got everything I need here. Like Sean said, he knows how I think, I know how he thinks. We both know what we need from each other in terms of work, and it gets done, you know what I mean?
What are you most excited about on the, you know, on this particular show? What are you most looking forward to?
Well, it's a little bit of a step up, like every fight, but particularly I'm happy to be back in Manchester. My last fight was in London, so a lot of my friends couldn't make it down just because the timing, how far it was. So I'm happy to have my support back, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I want to show where I've come from since the last time they've seen me fight. You know what
I mean? People who haven't seen you fight yet,
yeah,
tell us why they should get behind you, you know, and what you're going to bring to the table for them to...
Well, this fight, I'm going to bring a very calculated performance, but if I smell blood, I'm not going to think twice.
Yeah.
That's exactly why. If that's not a good reason, then I don't know.
But it's all mature, you know, it's all mature. You've got to take that in a calculated manner and still not be reckless about it. So that's all about the learning. That's the learning phase of what he's going through.
Yeah.
Knowing when to act on this, calibrating all the time. Resetting, calibrating, that's about maturing as a fighter.
Yeah, yeah. And you know, he's got a big future in front of him if he does everything you tell him and you know, he sticks to
100%. This is
keep the distractions away.
I'm so confident about where he's heading.
Yeah.
He can be the only one that can undo that.
Yeah.
You know, he's a very, very smart young man, a very responsible young man at 19 years old. We decided, listen, for 2 weeks he won't go and see his family in Accrington before his fight. He does it. I don't need to be worried about him going clubbing or anything else. There's only a few around of those fighters where they're so dedicated at a young age to what they want. And I'm lucky to have one.
Well, listen, best of luck at the Ultimate Boxer competition with Sean. And I really hope he lives up to the promise, because he's such a nice lad as well as being
definitely
a boxer.
Definitely.
We'll catch up with you very soon.
Thank you.
Sean?
Thank you.
Take care, man.
Cheers, okay.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.